Battery light is on,
12 volts,
not good. Today we have a Dodge Grand Caravan with a problem. Alternator doesn't charge the battery before firing the parts cannon. We have to do basic diagnosis, troubleshooting, and find why our alternator doesn't want to charge the battery. I have no idea what's wrong. Let's confirm the issue and get this van fixed and get back on the road. Let's get started. For the test, we need a simple basic multimeter. This one's inexpensive, but it's good enough. Before going to confirm the issue, starting the engine, let's check the current battery voltage in my multimeter. You can see, and we're going to probe right at the post, not at the clamp, not at the cable, right at the post, at the middle. All right, let's touch the positive and touch the negative, and we have 12.6 volts. Perfect, battery is fully charged, good start. Yeah, let's go start the engine and see what charging voltage we'll get from the alternator. Okay, start the engine and yeah, see what we have. All right, keys on, motor prime, let's crank it over. Engine fired right up, vehicle is idling, and as you can see here, we have the battery light is illuminating. It's telling us we have a problem with the charging system, it's not happy. Yeah, we're running from the battery. Let's go outside and check the charging voltage at the battery post. Okay. All right. Let's see what we have. And we're testing from the posts. Touching here and there. And we have 12 volts. Alternator is not charging. We're running from the battery. We don't have sufficient voltage. As you can see, 12 volts, not good. Eventually, vehicle will run out of power and everything will get shutted off. Yeah. Well, let's check them. Make sure pulley is spinning. As you can see, belt is running the pulley. Alternator supposed to charge the battery. Everything mechanically intact. We don't hear any weird noises. Belt tension is fine, no issues about that, and you can see shaft is spinning. Yeah, let me get my phone in, you can see. Yeah, it's turning. All right, good. Check. Right, let's increase the engine RPM and see if we'll have any alternator respond. Nothing. On some vehicles you can see the low charging voltage at idle, but this is not the case with Dodge. Next, we're going to check the voltage directly at the alternator. We'll put it here, our multimeter, and we'll set our negative here at the post and touch the threaded part of the stud. And we have 12 volts straight at the stud. It means we don't have a charging voltage right at the alternator. Let me show you. As you can see, I'm touching right at the stud, not at the wire, not at the eye link, just at the center of the stud. Well, we're not charging. Checking the charging voltage at the battery and checking at the alternator. We didn't see any voltage drop. Let's set our multimeter to lower range scale. You see the millivolts. And I'm going to touch the positive here and go to the positive on the alternator and see what voltage drop we have. We have 0.003 millivolts, which is literally nothing. We don't want to see more than 25 millivolts around that. Almost no voltage drop. Let's see if we have any issue with a poor ground. I'm touching the ground terminal and going to the alternator housing where it's grounded to the vehicle chassis. Let's see what we have here on the ground side. And we have a good ground, 0.006 volts on the ground side. Beautiful. Means integrity of the cable, our connections, all good. Tested. We have more tests to do at the alternator. We have a plug with the two wires. Let's get there. Before going to do a couple more tests at the alternator, at that connector and the plug with the two skinny wires, let's just take a brief look on charging system wiring diagram for 3.3, 3.8 liters engine. This diagram is for Dodge Caravan. And we have a generator, aka alternator, our fuse box, our battery, and our computer power control module. And we already checked this part of the electrical circuit. There's thick, big, heavy red wire going from the battery to the starter, from the starter to the generator, alternator. And over here is a fusible link. If you need to check the power on the wire, make sure if you don't have any juice coming to the battery, that might be your problem. And we don't have any issues with that. We checked the voltage drop and we checked the grounds. Now we're going down to the plug, two wires, field control, brown, gray. And on this wire, we're looking for voltage around 4.5 volts. And we're going to use just a multimeter. If we'll go and connect a scope, we'll see the square wave switching signal from the ECU to the alternator, pulling down to the ground like that. And we'll just see this steady voltage with the alternator. We're looking for 4.55 volts. Okay, and next, our the sense wire. This little guy, brown, with a white tracer. And on this wire, when ASD relay is on, we'll should see the battery voltage. This wire is sensing actual battery voltage. Yeah, pretty much it. And if you don't have any power on this wire, check the fuse number 1625 amps, 8 feet ASD relay over here. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Very basic, straightforward circuit. Let's go and do the checks. We're back. I got sidetracked a little bit with more important things to do, and it's dark. It's 6:30 p.m. and it's minus 5 degrees Celsius. Pretty cold. We have two more wires to check before calling the faulty alternator field circuit and a sense circuit. Yeah. Let's get down to the alternator plug, which is down there. Let's unplug it from the back of the alternator. Here we go. And we have two wire. This brown white is a sense wire. We should see the battery voltage on this wire. This part of the circuit actually measures actual battery voltage to let a voltage regulator know how much voltage to put back in the battery to charge it properly. And this next wire to it, it's brown gray. It looks black and dark, but it's actually brown gray, and that's a field circuit. And the field circuit supplies a voltage to the alternator's rotating field coil. Yeah, let's check our sense wire first, but before going and doing that, let's inspect the connector, make sure we don't have spreaded terminals, rusties, crusties. Everything looks just fine visually. Let's also do the drag test. I have a needle probe, and what I do, and I just put my probe in and push it and feel how much drag I have. And I can feel it. It's pretty tight. Good. terminators are not loose, not spread it apart. Let's do the another wire, and it's same way. You can feel the good connection on those two terminals. Okay, let's get our multimeter ready. Turn it to the volts. I have another alligator clamp connected to the battery negative, and we're going to our sense circuit first, which is a brown white. I think this guy. This first one. Let's just probe it. And when we start the vehicle, we should see battery voltage. Let's see what battery voltage is. And we have 12.5, but vehicle is not running. It will drop when we start the vehicle because we will have so many things turned on and it will run on out on a battery. Okay, my probe is all way in on a brown white wire, which is a sense circuit. Let's go start our van. Look at that, cold, dark, and it's getting cold. All right, but nothing can stop us. I want to get it done. Okay, keys on. Let's start the vehicle. Okay, vehicle started up. Vehicle is idling. Engine is running. We have a steel battery light illuminating. Okay, let's see what we have. And we have 11.8 volts, which is good. We have a sense circuit functioning properly, and voltage regulator will know what the actual battery voltage is. Let's switch to our field wire, which is a modulated signal from the ECM, and it's should be around 4.55 volts. It's a switching circuit. If we'll connect the scope, we'll see the square wave, but at least we want to see the voltage. Here we go. We have a 4.6 volts. ECU is commanding alternator to turn on. It pulls the circuit down, and it should charge, but we're not charging. Let's just reconnect our plug and back. Okay, and we'll go to the battery and see what we have. And we're not charging. We're draining the battery, running the vehicle from the battery. Yeah, from point on we can tell that our alternator is getting everything it needs to charge the battery. And it's not working. It doesn't want to charge. It means we have to put a new alternator. That's the way to go. If this video is helpful, informational, put a thumbs up. Very appreciated that. Subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for doing that. I have an alternator removed. New one is getting in. It was pretty easy. Yeah, good design. Very, very straightforward. And it's lots of room. Yeah, replacement video will be down in the description. Check it out. By the way, alternator we just removed was installed at 127,261 kilometers. Good used alternator is installed. And what we have a Densa made in Japan. Tested, good one. Doesn't look pretty, but this one works. All right, let's start a vehicle. And my multimeter is connected. Good to go. Let's go turn the key on and see what's up. All right, and we have, as you can see here, 196,854 kilometers, and means our old alternator lasts 69,500 kilometers. Okay, let's turn the key to the wrong position. Battery line came on, disappeared. Let's crank it. Here we go. And okay, after disconnecting the battery, my radio is off the stations and no more illuminating battery light. Let's go outside and see the voltage. Here we go. And voila, we have 14.3 volts, alternator is putting. Sweet, everything's working. Beautiful. Well, discharging the battery. Well, that's it for today. I hope you like it. If you do, yeah, there's more videos to watch, and see you soon. Yeah, take care. Bye-bye. Fix. I have to put a tire back and a shield to clean my tools. It's getting cold.